In SOC, Sounds of Cultura, the Phoenix Art Museum will present Order, Chaos, and the Space Between, Contemporary Latin American Art from the Diane and Bruce Halle Collection. It's an exhibition of contemporary works produced today in Latin America. Joining me to talk about the exhibition is Jim Ballinger, Phoenix Art Museum Director. Also here is Dr. Vanessa Davidson, Curator of Latin American Art for the Phoenix Art Museum. Thank you both for joining us on Horizonte. Jim, let's start with you, though, to tell us a little bit about how the collection came to be. We know that the Halles are noted art collectors, but how did it come to be that they made the decision to do this exhibition?
Diane Halle has been involved with the museum for over two decades, and in the mid-90s was looking to form a collection that could make a difference, with the idea that it would make a difference really here in Phoenix. So in 1995, they bought their first work, and over the last 18 years, it is an exhibition that has grown and collections grown into the hundreds of pieces. So to have this exhibition with about 50 works of art by 40 artists carefully selected by Vanessa and by the Halle's own curator, Beverly Adams, is just an incredible opportunity for this community to get a flavor of what's going on all over South America, particularly, and Mexico as well.
And this is consistent with what the museum has been doing the last several years in terms of enhancing its focus in this area.
Yeah, and as you know, Jose, from the very beginning, the Art Museum's been involved with the Art of Mexico. We've continually kind of grown and expanded what we're doing. So Vanessa's coming here with an endowed position as a curator is part of this growth. We've done major exhibitions with the most recent one, Mexican Modernism from Mexico City 3 years ago, which was a smash success here. And I think this will be too. I mean, and here it's artists making a difference, artists in the museum right now. One of the pieces we'll discuss tonight is being installed for right in front of people's eyes as they walk into the lobby of the museum. So it's a really great opportunity, and it's also an effort of the Halles with some of the projects we're doing is to bring ASU and the Art Museum together. There's a lot of commingling, if you will, of things with the art department, and we even have Darren Petrucci, who's an architecture professor at the university, has created the primary design of the galleries for us. So it's just a terrific opportunity. The museum's going to look in a way that it has never looked before, which is really exciting.
Well, Dr. Davidson, you come to us from New York, where you had a very distinguished career. Tell us a little bit about that and what brought you to Phoenix, and then we're going to get into the specifics of the exhibition.
Well, really, when I heard about this job opportunity, I looked into the Phoenix Art Museum's past and tried to imagine where it would go in the future. I saw, for example, that in 1957, 2 years before the museum was even officially founded, there was an exhibition of a Mexican modernist painting. It was followed in 1968 by a Rufino Tamayo retrospective, in 78 by a Frida Kahlo show, 84, Diego Rivera, The Cubist Years, which is a landmark exhibition. I followed the museum's history little by little, trying to see where they had come from and where they might be going. And in my conversations with the museum staff during my interview process and also with Mr. Ballinger, I realized that there was so much room for expansion, so much room for growth in this collection beyond Mexico. I think that since we are neighbors with Mexico, we tend to focus our sites just south of the border, but I think that it would be really a wonderful opportunity for us as for our whole community of residents in Phoenix and the Greater Valley to look a bit further south. And to look at Cuba, to look at the Dominican Republic, to look at Puerto Rico, to look to Brazil, not only to Mexico. And that's one of the things that this exhibition helps to bring about. This exhibition is truly revolutionary, I think, in two ways. The first way is that it will be the first time in the museum's history that we'll have so many seminal works of art from such diverse countries as Brazil, Argentina, Colombia, Cuba, Peru, Ecuador, Venezuela and Mexico under one roof. So we'll be collecting these diverse works and showing them to best effect in this exhibition. And the second way it will be revolutionary, I think, is that it will help broaden our audience's horizons beyond Mexico. It will create a space between, if you will, between what current perceptions of what Latin American art is and hopefully what they will gain from the exhibition is a more nuanced understanding of how rich and diverse and complex the artistic manifestations from Latin American art actually are.
Now, I want to talk about some of the specific pieces, but before I do that, just a few words about your background and your work in New York.
Sure. I received my PhD from the Institute of Fine Arts at the New York University. While I lived in New York, I worked at the Metropolitan Museum on a colonial show, actually. It was called The Colonial Andes, Textiles and Silverwork from 1530 to 1830. And I gained a lot of experience working at the Metropolitan there for 3 years. I very nearly went the colonial route. And I think part of my attraction to this job in particular in Phoenix was that we also have a wonderful collection of colonial art, which maybe perhaps people don't recognize up on the second floor there in the galleries. I hope people will go and take a second look. But I was very attracted to this museum and this collection because of its strengths in both colonial and 20th century art.
So focusing now on the contemporary art that's in this collection, we have, I think, about five photographs of pieces that we're going to throw up on the screen and discuss them as they come up. The first one, a Brazilian artist. Tell us
yes.
a little bit about him.
Yes, the first artwork is by a Brazilian artist called Antonio Dias. It was created in 1970, and it's called The Space Between. And it consists of a black granite cube.
Which we have up on the screen
speckled,
right now.
Yes, speckled with white dots, and a white marble cube speckled with black dots. And the black cube bears the words "the beginning," and the white cube the words "the end." So in this work, GS reminds us that although everything in life has a beginning and an ending, it's the space between that counts. And I think that it also evokes a continuous present, a time and a space and a latent state of becoming. And in this way, I think that this work serves as an apt metaphor for the Halle Collection itself, which continues to grow and evolve and expand in new directions.
And the next piece we're going to put up, I think, is the piece that Jim was talking about when he said that people will have an opportunity to see before the exhibition opens. Actually, it's being prepared right now.
It's being prepared as we speak right now. It's called Black Cloud. It's by a Mexican artist named Carlos Amorales from 2007. And I think that what is so intriguing about this artwork, beyond its haunting beauty, is that it really turns the technique of collage on its head. Because collage, we associate collage with paper upon paper or paper upon canvas. But what Amorales has done here is turned the gallery space itself into a canvas for collage. So what you see when you come to this work is what from afar looks like a hovering black cloud above the exhibition space. When we draw closer, what you see are a series of surrealistic insects poised in sculptural formations upon the wall. And each one of those 30,000 paper moths and butterflies has been painstakingly pasted to the wall by hand.
Now the next one, Jim, you're going to have trouble keeping the school kids away from this one. And actually, as I understand it, on this next one that we're going to put up on the screen, you want people to partake of this particular exhibition.
Yeah, the tourist Garcia has 75 pounds of candy, and the viewer is actually invited to take a piece of candy from that piece. I think it's about the temporal life we're all in. You watch this thing kind of get smaller and smaller. It's also a metaphor for the artist partner who passed away. Had to do with the inception of some of this work, with kind of watching a life go from beginning to end. Like, and it comes back to the exact metaphor that Vanessa was talking about. So this whole idea with the title of order and chaos and the space between is a very kind of almost literal interpretation for me of the polarity of Latin American art since World War II.
Now, Vanessa, we've got two more pieces we want to get through quickly before we run out of time.
Sure.
This next one is
By the Venezuelan artist called Carlos Cruzies, and he was one of the protagonists of the kinetic art movement in Venezuela. And what's so interesting about Cruzies is that he really transformed color and light, the effects of light, into his raw materials. And so what we have in these transformees, which date from 1965 to 2008 when they were refabricated, are slats of plexiglass sheets of color. And when you move around the work, you look through these slats of plexiglass, you get a new perception of color. The colors commingle upon your retina, and they create a very interesting optical effect. And as in most of the kinetic artworks from Venezuela, the piece itself does not move, but the spectator is the kinetic element. So you as a spectator make the work kinetic.
And this last one reflects some of the turmoil that has yes. often engulfed various Latin American countries.
Yes,
over the
it
years.
Does. It's by the Colombian artist Doris Salcedo. Salcedo is Colombian, and of course, as we all know, Colombia has gone through a terrible many decades now of violence, paramilitary violence, drug war violence, civil war. But what Salcedo has done in this work, which is called Atrabiliarios, Atrabiliarios is an untranslatable title, but it comes from the Latin term Atrabilis, which comes from Atratus in mourning and bilis, rage, so Atrabiliarios. And what she has done in this work is to collect women's shoes who were disappeared, or desaparecidos, and she's cut rectangular niches into the wall and placed a shoe or a pair of shoes inside, and then sewn up this wound with a suture of surgical thread, and with animal skins in front of them. And the shoes are symbolic because often when people went missing, their bodies could be identified in mass graves only by the shoes they wore at the time of the execution.
And that was all that was left. Jim, we're almost out of time. We've got the information about the exhibition on the screen and. Book that just came off the press.
Today, we're very proud of, which is a series of articles, Vanessa, Beverly, and other scholars documenting this exhibition. I was taken by leafing through it, Jose, how accessible this work really is. And to the kinetic idea, there's a lot of interactivity going on in this show. The scale of things, the powerful color, I think are attractions to people that normally wouldn't be drawn to contemporary
art. I'm sure
it would
be a great attraction. I'm also sorry we're out of time, so... Thank you both for being here. That's our show for tonight. From all of us here at Horizonte, I'm Jose Cardenas. Have a good night.